Hello Twin Flames, thank you for being here, for liking, subscribing and all the beautiful comments and feedback you leave me. It means the world, as you know. And if you are new to the channel, subscribe, join this beautiful family because we're here for you every day. I am hoping to go live in the next couple of days. The weather is so up and down, I just can't predict it and I don't really want it buffering on you guys. So do bear with me. I will be live, so make sure your notification bell's on. So, yesterday, three powerful, very powerful channeled messages. One from the feminine to the masculine to the feminine, and one from the angels about the journey. And I was so blessed and grateful the angels gave me those messages to share this love and hope with us all. So if you haven't watched those, go and watch them. The last three videos that I posted for the Twin Flames, powerful channeled messages. So today we're going to tune in and see how those messages affect the energy. So I'm going to use five decks of cards today. So we're going to go in depth. I'm going to use the Oracle of Visions cards. I'm going to use the Enchanted Map Oracle because we have to find our way to union. I'm going to use the Good Witch or the Everyday Witch or whatever these ones are. I think these are just the Witch Tarot, to be honest. I've got so many Witch Tarot decks, I'm not sure. But I'm pretty sure this is the Witch Tarot. I'm going to use the Dragon Oracle because the dragons are around us, clearing the air, bringing in fresh energy. And the Sacred Geometry Activations Guidebook, which I absolutely love this Oracle deck because this is like Archangel Metatron when he's clearing the chakras. And Archangel Metatron, the Divine Time Angel, the angel that heals us, is around us all today. So thank you, angels. What do we need to know for this amazing day as we're going into the month of March? So what do we need to know for the feminines, please, angels? What do we need to know for the Divine Feminines today? What guidance have you got for the Divine Feminines today? They're just closing throat chakra a little bit. So, you know, again, some fears over communication issues coming through. What for the journey? So I've got a card there for the Feminines, the Masculines and the Journey. It's gone back in there. Okay, I'm doing what I'm guided to do as always. What do we need to know for the Feminines today, please, angels? I'm taking out anything that I'm guided to. For the masculines today, please, what do we need to know? For the divine masculines, thank you. I'm taking out those ones. And for the journey, what do we need to know for the journey? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Amazing. And there's a card sticking out there. What do we need to know for the feminines today, please, angels? Wow, look at that. What do we need to know for the divine masculines today? Wow, okay. And what do we need to know for the journey? Amazing. Okay, I love it when the cards jump out. I get so excited. What do we need to know for the feminines? Wow, look at that. That was a jumper for effect, that was. And these are the dragon cards. So the dragons are jumping all over it. What do we need to know for the divine masculines, please, angels? What do we need to know for the masculines? Wow, look at that, okay. What do we need to know for the journey right now? What guidance have you got for us for the journey, please? Wow, that one. And any more? It's gone back in. There we go. Is it coming out? Yeah. They will stick out and jump out if they're meant to. The angel will be like, no, you need to take that card, Liz. Divine Feminines, what do we need to know? Divine Masculines, wow. Okay, on the floor for the Masculines and the Journey. So there's quite a few cards coming out. So this may be, again, another longer reading. If you have noticed lately that the readings are getting a bit longer, it's because there's so much change coming in. You know, the angels will always guide us and show us the way. So I'm going to start today with the Divine Feminine because I'm super excited for what's happening with the Feminine's journey right now. You know, there's so much change coming in and wow, look at this. Straight away, you've got the Queen of Wands. So it's showing you that you're in your power right now. You know, you're in your power, you're standing strong. You're being authentic, you're being true. And even though you've got a mask on there, it's because you're realizing how strong you are. You may need to wear a mask when you're in the outside world, which means people, you know, don't understand you. So you may be a different person to others than you are with other people, which means with your family here, you're your true, authentic self. Out there in the real world, you may put a mask on. So the masculines are very different than the feminines in that way. It's kind of like a reflection energy. Because the masculine's put a mask on towards the feminine, towards their spiritual journey, and they try and be their authentic self in the real world. Whereas feminines, you're your authentic self on your spiritual path, and you wear a mask around the real world. And you know, there's things going on right now in the world with coronavirus, where people are wearing masks out there in the real world. So everything's reflected in the journey, and the angels are saying that there, this is you standing your ground, being strong, being powerful, being who you are. Obviously, if you're a fire sign, it's showing you you're standing strong as well. This may be an extra message in there for you, but this is every one of us, all of us right now, standing strong. And we've got decisions to make, you know. There's opportunities around us right now, choices to be made. There's so much we can do. And this is Archangel Raziel kind of coming in and going, no, wait. You know, there's no need to rush anything because the masculine will come forward to you. So if you're wondering right now if you should reach out, what you should do, it's showing the masculine will take action to you. So all you have to do is breathe, relax, enjoy the journey, start to embrace the journey and be you. This is you standing in your power here, working out what you want, working out finances, getting things in order. And if it feels like a dry desert, then the water is coming. You have to keep the faith, trust the journey, trust the process. The desert is, you know, things can sometimes feel a bit barren, like there's nothing around for miles, like you can't see an end in sight. And the angel is saying, keep the faith, the journey is flowing. We've got the golden solar dragon, helps you stand in your masculine power with wisdom. So this is about you, divine feminine, seeing the masculines in their power and embracing that power. It's also about you embracing your masculine side, because as a twin flame, we take on one of the roles of the energies. So if you're predominantly in feminine energy, then you're feeling strong. But at times you need to be in your masculine energy to deal with the real world. And that's really what I'm feeling when I'm tuning into this card, connected with the mask. That, you know, sometimes we have to be strong in our energy and we have to really say how we feel. And this can come across as a bit cool in the outside world, especially if we're setting boundaries. You know, we don't want to be around negative energy anymore. So we may be putting up barriers, the way the masculines put barriers up to the feminine. So you have to really understand that this is a journey of soul growth and learning. And it's also a journey of mirroring each other. Let your DNA be reprogrammed and light codes activated. Become an inspired leader. So this dragon is guiding you to become an inspired leader, because you're leading the way every day, finding yourself in the darkness. And we've got the source dragon, so powerful. This dragon is saying to you that you are connected with source, the infinite wisdom, the universe, the creator. You're tapped in, tuned in, turned on to source energy. And this dragon is opening up that connection. Be still. In the silence, magic can happen. Be in the moment. So this is about being in the present moment. Always. That's where your power is. Any fear or worry or doubt, it's always created from a worry about the future or thinking about the past. It's gone. It can't be changed. So you have to stay in the now, in the stillness of the now, and get your mojo back. The angels are showing you the rainbow dragon. I love this. This is protection. It's showing the sun coming out. Angel blessings, protective from heaven, brings the leap of joy that opens new doors. So you're being shown that doors are opening. Even if it feels like it's a dry desert, the door is opening. They're showing me this cactus in the far off here, you know, in the horizon. This is like the doorway opening. So you have to keep the faith through it all. Have trust, rediscover wisdom, expect miracles, accept opportunities. So opportunities, miracles coming in, doors opening. You have to trust and keep the faith. And wow, Look at this, Divine Feminine. We've got the number 11, which signifies compassion, awakenings, realizations, and the belief in the journey. We've got the belief card. I absolutely love this coming out for the feminine here. It's showing you that you're starting to believe. You're gaining infinite wisdom. You're plugged into source. You know who you are. The frequency of belief supports our sense of self-worth based on our gifts and talents and a strong connection to source. Wow. And you've got the source dragon here. This is absolutely beautiful. And I have to be honest, I've used this deck of cards, the source, the dragon cards, a lot of times. And this is the first time this card's come out. So I'm absolutely loving it, especially connected with the belief, because it's showing you that your belief systems are changing. You know, and the angels are showing me that even listening to that channeled message from the masculines, it's put a sense of belief back into your core DNA structure. It's helped you to feel better. And that's amazing. It's like a kid at Christmas, how much belief they've got. And if you've ever seen the film Elf, you know that they have to kind of sing to get the Christmas spirit back. That's what helps Santa's sleigh get off the ground. And it's the same kind of belief in magic, belief in the power of the universe, belief in source energy. We've got the royal blue and gold dragon. I love this. Strengthens you to stand in your power with wisdom. So the dragons are helping you tune into source, helping you to remember who you are, to give you infinite wisdom. So around you, Divine Feminine, you've got real powerful, strong dragons guiding you, leading the way, showing you the truth, awakening you to your own majesty. Wear your cloak of power with pride. And this dragon's very much connected with Archangel Michael. The blue colours, the sword there, the strength, the understanding, the belief system, the connection with source. So this is showing you that you're in your power today, standing strong, and you don't have to do anything because your masculine will come to you. So even if there's opportunities, if you're wanting to reach out right now, but you're wanting to do it with expectation, Archangel Raziel is just saying, wait, hold fire, do you, and trust that everything is falling into place. So powerful. Wow. Okay, then let's do the Divine Masculines then. Let's do the Masculines then. So, well, there's conflict around the Masculines right now. And it's showing that, and again, this came up yesterday, you know, because they're fixing their wings right now. They're fixing their broken wings. So they're in conflict with themselves over what to do. And we've got the Death card. So they're going through change and transformation. Things are being healed. We've got the High Priest, which is very much about the Masculines becoming the Emperor. Standing in their power, listening to their intuition, realizing that this is a journey of self-belief, self-worth and healing. They're starting to learn how to fly. And this is the wings. I love this because it really resonates with the message from yesterday. They're learning to fly. They want to wake up. They're realizing things. They're flying free. And we've got the Earth Dragon coming through because they're being grounded right now. Things are being removed out of the way. Change coming in, especially connected with fear. They're giving me that burpee energy there. Earth Dragon clears your path and the land around you. So the Earth Dragons are helping the Divine Masculine to remove obstacles out of the way, to clear their path. This is how they're going to move away from anything no longer serving them, any karmic situations. They're clearing the way. And the angels say, stay grounded. Be ready to serve. Stuck energy is clearing. You can move forward in life. So the Masculines are starting to be shown that they can move forward, that they don't have to feel stuck, that the obstacles in their path are being removed. And we've got Sunshine Yellow Dragon. And I love that because Sunshine is my guardian angel. And last night, me and George watched a film called Legend with Tom Cruise. Very old film. You know, Tom Cruise was very young when he made that. And it's about, you know, darkness and light. And I love it because it reminds me of this card because, you know, in that film, there was like Tim Curry played this devil creature, like the Dark Lord. And he wanted to get rid of the light in the world so he could rule and rule stronger. And, you know, it was he had to kill a unicorn and cut its horn off, because the unicorn's horn is the power that really points to heaven, to source. And that power's within you at all times. And the Dark Lord kind of came in and said, I need that horn because sunshine is my destroyer. And I thought, wow, sunshine is the destroyer of darkness. So obviously light always overcomes darkness, but connected with the divine masculine, their darkness is now being overwhelmed with light. So sunshine, which is you, divine feminine, shining your light and being that sunshine, is the destroyer of the masculine's darkness. It's what will lead them into the light. And that was really, you know, kind of ingrained into me watching that film last night, because the angels will always show me things connected with the journey, just like they show you things every day connected with your journey, signs and synchronicities. And the masculine, it says, helps you to help animals, to serve animals, to heal, respect and understand them. So the masculines are being healed right now through animals, which means their animal guides are around them stronger than ever. And it means that they'll be seeing animals, signs, synchronicities, and animals in the real world to bring in healing, to show them their compassionate side, to destroy the darkness, to remove any fear. So animals around the masculines right now, bringing in compassion and understanding. We've also got the water dragon. And I love this because, you know, so much rain around right now, purifying everything, cleansing everything. And the masculines are going through a purification. And this is showing that they are being healed through water. So the earth dragons are removing obstacles, and the water dragons are clearing the way, removing things, helps you flow easily around obstacles. So the earth dragons are removing obstacles, and the water dragons are helping them to go round the obstacles. So really, they've got no option but to move forward to you, to take required action, guided action. It says, Christ's light and love are flowing. Develop your psychic abilities and go with the flow. So the masculines are being guided to go with the flow. And that's also what you're being guided to do, feminine, to go with the flow. Now, these cards are beautiful. First of all, how powerful is this one? We've got the divine masculine card coming out for the divine masculine. The number 22. And this is really significant, this number right now, because it means working together. It means working together as a partnership. Feminine and masculine coming together. Feminine and masculine energies molding together. Power, strength, the blue light from above. I also feel serious energy around this card, and I'm tuning in with Archangel Michael. The frequency of divine masculine supports our strong, focused and active side, allowing it to express itself while helping us to bring our dreams and ideas into form with kindness and wisdom. So this makes a lot of sense with that channeled message, because the masculine's higher self is guiding them to take action, to communicate, to express themselves, and they are expressing themselves to you. Why? Because of the passion they feel for you. The passion and the universal love. So the passion is very real. It comes from the very core of their being and it rises up. The frequency of passion reminds us that beneath every intense emotion lies the hidden gem of insight, balance and calm. It assists us in finding the balance within the intensity, moving us from chaos to the calm of its core, where we can let its long-lasting wisdom fill us up. So this is the masculine's being filled up with wisdom, feeling it all, being in the energy of passion, sexual energy, drive, motivation to move this forward, because it's universal love. And we've got 44 angel protection. So the masculines are being guided, protected. The frequency of universal love activates the connection we feel to each other, to our planet and the whole of existence itself. So the universal love is bringing you and your divine masculine closer together. And we've got Gaia coming through here, the power of heaven, the power of the earth, the connection between the 3D and the 5D, the bonds getting stronger. So it's about a connection. The frequency of Gaia reminds us that we are infinitely connected to one another, just as we are to our great mother and to the universe that birthed us all. So this is about your connection, and it's about the masculines feeling that connection. It's about the masculines tuning into source, tuning in with the earth, grounding themselves, feeling everything. So the angels are saying this is more the masculines tuning in with the here and now rather than being out there in society. So they're starting to wake up. We've got soul time. So the masculines are waking up to soul time. They're realizing that time is illusion. That it's time for them to work on their soul journey. That it's time for their soul path now. It's time. It's time to do what they're being driven to do. The frequency of soul time asks us to allow the possibility of a new reality to emerge. Wow. A new reality. So they're going for their soul now, their soul's journey, instead of listening to the outside world. One that embraces the concept that while the corporal body is mortal, the soul is timeless, limitless and infinite. So they're starting to realize that they are a soul in a physical body. They're starting to realize everything that you already know. So have patience, because this is powerful. And we've got the earth card coming in for the masculines. So again, some of your masculines may be earth signs, and they may be being grounded more than ever right now, shown the way. Because as well, the earth dragons are around the masculines. So there's a lot of grounding going on with the masculines right now, bringing them back down to earth, healing them. The frequency of earth activates our deep connection to this physical plane by showing us the beauty of all the aspects of our great mother and revealing the more ethereal spiritual aspects of our nature. So tuning in with infinite wisdom, giving us power, giving us strength, and the masculines are feeling all of this. So such amazing energy coming in for the divine masculine. Power and strength, seeing the truth, water dragons, earth dragons around the masculines. And it's so amazing because, you know, there's powerful dragons, source dragons around the feminine. And then you've got the kind of everyday dragons around the masculines, which weighs up the journey to a T. For the journey then, wow, okay. So it's about rising through fear. Look at this for powerful. Being reborn, there's a rebirth going on, activation. We've got the Nine of Cups, the wish card there, dreams coming true. We've got the Seven of Swords. And in this deck, I always see this as the masculine smiling, getting his act together, deciding what to do, becoming the King of Wands. So again, a lot of fire energy around this deck, around this reading, around the journey. Celebrations coming in, the Four of Wands, showing the power coming in over the next 4 weeks. It's showing there's demons around, you know, goblins. So this is very much about the fear. You know, when I say demons, it's about, you know, facing your demons, facing your fears, you know, realizing that you have to overcome the darkness to be in the light. And once again, goblins. In legend last night that I watched, there was goblins. A goblin cut off the unicorn's horn. You know, so it's fear again. And it shows that goblins or dark energy fears the light, because the light is pure. Unconditional love is pure. You know, it's never ending. It conquers all. So you have to trust in this energy. You know, if the light wasn't so powerful, the darkness wouldn't try and overcome it. You know, the darkness wouldn't be afraid of it. It just shows that anything that feels stuck in the wind is changing, you know. And this is stuck in the mud, that's what it says. But they're saying stuck in the wind, because the wind of change is coming in. And you're the elephant, you know, you're the elephant. It's always in the room. which means wherever your masculine goes, you're always in the room with them, in their mind, in their thoughts, stuck in the mud. There's no removing you from their mind, and vice versa. Somebody said, you know, should we forget our twin? You know, of course you can never forget your twin. Why would you want to? You know, wherever your twin is teaching you, it's healing you. So why would you want to forget a part of you? You know, when you're doing your work and healing yourself and working on self-love, then you don't kind of forget your twin. You just move into a calmer place. So your twin's always with you anyway. It's about calming your energy and your, yeah, the fear, thank you, calming the fear. Because the goblins are the fear and the elephant is what's removing that fear with the power of the connection, the power of the love. The elephant showing you that like an elephant, it never forgets. So it's about knowing that you can never forget your twin and your twin can never forget you. The elephant is coming. We've got the golden Christy dragon, so powerful here. Brings you higher love so that you embody the Christ light. So on the journey, it's about bringing in higher love, which is all about unconditional love, understanding that the energy is golden, infinite wisdom. Absorb the Christ light. You are protected. Expand your heart and remain fifth dimensional. So remain in the 5D, which means stay in your love and light and your heart space. Meet your twin on the 5D. Be in your higher power, compassionate, loving and understanding. And we've got the green dragon here. Helps you tune into the secrets of nature. And when you tune into nature, it brings out the secrets within you, the power within you, the strength within you. And the green is very healing. You know, nature is very healing. This is why Archangel Raphael is green in color, because he's a healing angel. And green is healing, and nature heals, and nature is green. Green grass, green trees. You know, the green lawns that you see, that beautiful smell of cut grass, it's very healing. We've got the fire dragon blasting everything away. And I really am feeling fire energy around the journey because there's so much healing coming in. A rebirth born in passion and strength and fire burns up the lower energies around you. So anything no longer serving you, including karmic situations, is being burned up. You know, the earth dragons are removing obstacles, the water dragons are helping the masculines go around the obstacles, and the fire dragons are burning things up. So they're removing things in their own way. You are safe and protected. Now that's twice that the angels have told you that through the cards for the journey. This journey is safe and protected. Be determined and inspired and clear your soul pathway, which is what's happening right now. We've got remembrance coming through for the journey, remembering the journey. Wow, and look at this before I read this card, a tantric journey. How amazing is that? For the journey, a tantric journey, which is about powerful sex, a connection, magic coming in, kundalini rising, the power of it all. So for the remembrance card, and I'm feeling this is about knowing each other, remembering who you are. It's also about knowing that you've got loving angels with you, the power of loved ones supporting you, ancestors. Things coming to your mind. The frequency of remembrance supports our memory of everything that we have gone through as a soul in a body, providing us with valuable information and tools to flow gradually and gracefully within this life. So this is showing you that you're remembering exactly who you are. And this is what the divine masculine is going through right now, because they're remembering who they are. So there's power coming into the connection, and the tantric journey, the frequency of tantric journey helps us to unlock the hidden knowledge and wisdom that we that we hold about how to reach a state of wholeness and completion through our sensual experiences with ourselves and with another. So this journey is sexual, powerful, intense. It's leading us where we need to be, bringing in that amazing connection that's integration, coming together, finding each other. This is beautiful. These cards are amazing today. The frequency of integration supports our embrace of every aspect of ourselves, allowing what we perceive as positive and what we perceive as negative to harmonize in a balanced symphony of life. So it's about yin and yang energy, polarity, light and dark, bringing everything together that will grow and flow like a cosmic flower, that will erupt into bliss, that will bring in strength energy. The frequency of cosmic flower activates our remembrance of the place we call home, the core from which we pour our magnificence out into the world. And, you know, this is about coming home. Masculines coming home to feminines, feminines embracing the masculines so that you can live your life powerfully and then return home together. So this is about power coming in, things blooming right now. An absolutely stunning reading to come in after those channeled messages. And that's why it was so important that I use this deck today. You know, the Sacred Geometry Activations Oracle, so powerful. I can really recommend this deck if you're a reader or you want to, you know, tune into the energy of the journey. So I hope that helps, you know. Also, today and tomorrow, I should have posted all the horoscope readings, and you guys have been asking me about the new layout for those. I'm doing 3 readings now for each sign per month. So I'm going to be doing a general reading, a twin flame reading, and a reading about the divine masculine. So if you're a Virgo, then you watch your Virgo general reading, you watch your Virgo twin flame reading, and then the corresponding reading connected with your masculine. So if you're a Virgo and your masculine is a Sagittarius, you would go and watch the divine masculine Sagittarius reading, and perhaps watch the readings about the their twin flame connections, you know, and their general reading, because it will bring in more guidance and it will help you to know what's going on. I am posting weekly readings. Not many people are watching them, yet you're emailing me saying, please, can you do weekly horoscope readings? I do that all on one video or on a live stream. And they go on a Sunday or at the latest on a Monday. So you'll be checking that out. Also, I'm going to be announcing later, I'm bringing in a new weekly series. Now, we're doing the Find Your Way to Union right now. There's also so much going on the channel, but they're also guiding me to start a new series. So I'm going to be announcing that later today. So look out for that video. So I hope you've enjoyed this. Let me know in the comments section how you're feeling today after those channel messages, if you're feeling stronger, if you're realizing the truth that your masculine loves you and is on their way. Trust in this. The divine masculine is opening doors right now. There's power coming in. Trust that these dragons are coming in today to do their work. And dragons are beings of love and light. They're like the unicorns. If you're wondering what the dragons are, they work mainly on the 4th dimension, you know, on the 4th dimension. They can work on the 2nd as well, because they're kind of, they go where the angels don't. You know, they go into dark places to heal things. They go where the unicorns don't go. So the dragons have a real purpose, and they are so healing and beautiful and magical creatures. They're here for you every day. You know, don't take what you see on films about dragons being scary and evil. Dragons are beautiful creatures up there with the unicorns. So trust in them, because they're working behind the scenes for you right now to bring in power and strength. I hope this helps. Have a magical day, and I'll see you soon.